Today we're going to draw head positions. It's very important to draw heads in different positions. So let's start here and get some shapes going. Simple block shapes. Actually, you can start with a globe shape and start to structure things in from there. We'll use a cartoony character, semi-realistic cartoony character, and use that so it's more simple. But let's just use a globe shape here and start to move it around and get the lines and arcs going to make sure that we can get the positions going. So this character will be looking up right now, and we put the globe and we push the actual middle center line where the eyes will be to look up a little bit more, and we push the line to make more of a three-quarter down the center of the globe. Now we'll shape in another position of the head. So we'll use the same character, block in simple shapes with a globe here first, and start to get the character to look down this time. It's very important to actually capture different directions of characters and heads when you're making your own characters. So let's start to carve in some of the lines here and get the eyes where the eye position will be. We started with a globe and we put a center line down, and then we push that line up a little bit and put the line there, and we map in where the eyes will be and then get the shape of this structure going here around the head and down into the neck. So it's very simple shapes, globes and like a square chin that's happening there. So here's another globe going the other side here. Go around with it and then start to mark in where we want to go. And we're going to have this one actually looking up here a little bit more. So we're going to push the angle of the globe shape where the line would go, where the eyes would go. Okay, and then get the top of the head to actually map in and use the simple shapes here with the rough drawing to block it in. So in this position, the character is actually looking up a little bit more. So let's get the globe part on the top and push that in and use the pencil to go around. I'm drawing the rough drawings in blue pencil because we want to add details afterwards. So let's push these shapes through here and just get a feel for where the character is going to be. There's a square chin that goes with the globe head. So we got the skull as a globe. And now let's get a position in the front that's actually looking towards the group. So once again, you're trying to get some staging and composition going within the actual movements of the character's head. And now we'll use this drawing in the front to actually have this character looking into the distance. So mark in where the ears will go, get the globe structure that's in there, and just map in where the chin's gonna be. So it's good practice to do this and get the character's head positions moving around. If you wanted to make a 3D model of the character, it gets a good understanding of the shapes of where they're going to be. And if you want to draw the character in 2D, it's also very good because it gets the dimension of the character going. Or if you wanted to get the storyboard going, it's a good way to start so that you can get an understanding of the different shapes and positions where the head's going to be. So let's mark in the lines here and get the chin marked in. And we'll use the thicker pencil to go over the block shapes that we have. So the actual lines that go down the middle here is for where the eyes will be. And there's a nose and then the mouth. So all those goes half, half, half to the bottom. And then we'll put a square chin that goes in here. So we'll mix in some round shapes with the straight edges. And we'll just get this character here. And put the neck that's going to add to the back here. So